Welcome to The Journey 2020. I'm Charles Morris, and normally you would see Dr. Robinson with the intro to the show, but Dr. Robinson is working on this open house today. As you know, he missed a few weeks working because he moved into a new facility, so today he's having his open house. I just left. He had a nice crowd. He is introducing his new building and some of the new programs that's going on in his new facility. So God is blessing him so he can bless other people. So he will be back on the show next week as part of the Black National AIDS Day as well. So you look forward to that. I got some information that I want to give to you. So let's get to that first. The Zora Festival is going to be this weekend. And as you see, the Isley Brothers are going to be live in concert on Saturday. And then on Sunday, Hezekiah Walker is going to be in concert. Now, if you were listening last week, you know, that was a good chance for you to win some tickets. So we was able to give away maybe about 6 pair of tickets to the concert. Again, that's actually tomorrow, Saturday and Sunday, Hezekiah Walker. Also, stay tuned because coming up, guess who's going to be on the show? That's right, Lucille O'Neill. She's coming up. We've been friends for quite probably about 8 or 9 years. And I asked her to come on the show. She's going to talk about her book that's been out for a while, Walk Like You Got Somewhere to Go. I had a chance to read it. And I said to her, I said, you know, we got a lot of things in common. And she kind of laughed, and I shared with her what I meant by it. And so she's going to come on and talk about that as well. Also, another one of my friends is coming on the show. Melva she's coming on to talk about her mother. She's going to bring her mother on the show. And she's going to talk about this book that she wrote that her mother was basically enslaved and men was forced upon her, and she had children, and even though she raised them, she's talking about what her mother went through and what it was like probably about some 70, 80 years ago. So that should be an interesting conversation. I think I covered everything. A few weeks ago, I was out at the Altamont Mall and had a chance to see the display and the promo for this wonderful show that I've heard of and had seen the promos in the past but have never seen the show. Struck up the conversation with Dr. Van Nguyen and want to thank her for her hospitality, for her kindness, and for taking the time to come on the show. And she brought with her Serene Lee with her, and they're here today to talk about this wonderful show that kind of reminds me of the Disney show Circus Olay. And so we asked them to come on the show and so they can introduce themselves. And thank you so much for coming on the show.
All right, my name is Van Nguyen, mm-hmm. and I am a fan, mm-hmm. and a volunteer promoter for the Shen Yun show, mm-hmm. too. I've been doing this for 5 years.
5 years?
Yes.
And how did you become involved with them?
How do I become involved with them? That goes back a little bit there. I went and watched the show, mm-hmm. and I, you know, initially I just love art and culture, and then I am a practitioner of Falun Gong, mm-hmm. and this is sponsored by the Falun Dafa Association.
So, I've been fascinated by you, by when you said, well, you know what, it's cold. And I was like, yeah. And you said, but I'm from Orlando. And so, but when I hear your accent, and then I'm like, oh, okay, so you're from Orlando.
Originally I'm from Vietnam.
There you go, okay. Yes. Okay, and so how did you end up in Orlando?
Oh, how do I end up in Orlando? Mm-hmm. Well, in 1975,
okay.
we escaped from the country, actually from the communists.
Okay.
So I pretty much, you know, identify myself with all the situation with China.
You can't say that then. You can't say I'm from Orlando.
But
I'm saying, see, that's what threw me off. Because when you say, well, I'm from Orlando, and I was like, huh? And I'm just, because you were saying you wasn't used to the cold. and not knowing where you was from.
Well, that's even worse. From Vietnam, there's no coal at all, right?
Okay. Well, yeah. See, now you just told me something that I did not know.
Well, you should ask me where you are originally from, because I've been here 41 years. So make me native of Orlando, right?
Okay, so you got to tell us, how did you come here again? Okay.
Well, I just escaped with many hundreds of thousands of people running away from the communist regimes. Mm-hmm. And then we end up in, you know, we're lucky enough to end up in America.
So when you say escape, so you're going to have to tell us what that means.
Well, the communists took over, you know, Saigon, which is the capital of the South Vietnam. Mm-hmm. So people who know about the communist regime, they don't want to stay there. Mm-hmm. And of course, they don't want us to leave the country. Mm-hmm. So we kind of have to escape, you know, by many means. You know, I flew, but other people went by boat depot and they got killed. Mm-hmm. A lot of people die.
Mm-hmm. So do you remember that?
Yeah.
And how old were you?
I was 24.
Oh, okay. I'm thinking you came over when you were a little kid.
No. I was 24. I just, you know, finished my medical school and I just left.
Okay. So how was that when you made that transition, coming from where you came from, going through that, mm-hmm. and then coming here? So how did that happen? How did you make that happen?
How do I make that happen?
How did that door open for you?
Well, it's you know, it's a long story. Mm-hmm. My family originally was from the North Vietnam.
Okay.
And then after the Geneva Agreement in 1954, mm-hmm. the communists, you know, took the North, and the South became the Republic of Vietnam. Okay. You know, three countries. So okay. We moved south. Mm-hmm. So now when the communists took over the South, there's no reason for us to stay there. Mm-hmm. So we have to find a way to leave.
Okay.
So, you know, when I came here, we just, you know, fought for our life, our freedom. I don't think about anything else. So, you know, when I came here, I was lucky enough just to go on with my medical thing. So that's
okay.
how it was.
So what inspired you to do that?
Inspired me to do...
To go into the medical field.
I just graduated becoming a doctor when I left the country.
No, but I'm saying, what inspired you to do... What inspired you to go into that field?
Oh, I like medicine, and you know, like when we were younger, mm-hmm. we always say we want to help people.
Right.
You know, of course, it changes through the, you know, mm-hmm. through time and stuff. But I always liked medicine, so you know, opportunity knocks, so I just follow. Because
okay.
I already finished medical school,
okay.
but when I came here, it just everything fell, you know, in order. So I just continue.
So now, how did that translate from where you came from to here into the medical field? I mean, how did they recognize your studies?
When I was in medical school in Vietnam, the school was sponsored by, you know, an American school here, Chicago
okay.
Medical School.
Okay.
So the transcript and everything, they have it.
Okay.
So I was lucky enough where they recognize it. You know, just go on. They have all my files and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So then I just continue, and I did my residency in Little Rock, Arkansas.
Okay.
And the governor of the state at that time sponsored me out to the school.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Now we get to hear your story. give us a little history.
Oh, history? I'm not that old.
Well, right.
Okay. I was originally from China.
Okay.
And then I want to study in Australia.
And see, I'm already jealous.
Australia, right?
I mean, I'm already jealous.
Right.
You know,
yeah.
So, you know, because you're worldly, you know, but, you know.
I just study abroad. That was, it's very trendy for Chinese students to go overseas to study. Mm-hmm. And that even nowadays,
Is that hard?
Really
hard?
Now it's become more and more easier, and my time is a little hard, but it's more and more easier for Chinese to study overseas. Yeah.
Okay.
And self-funded. And and then I come to United States to work.
Okay.
Yeah. And I actually almost the same field as you. I work for Chinese TV network in New York.
Uh-huh.
Yeah,
oh, really?
Journalist.
Really? See, for people who don't understand, working, you're based on the market. And for people who don't understand, New York is one of the biggest markets. And if you're in this business, it's hard to get into the New York market.
Mm.
You have to go through these stages the lower market to get to a place like Los Angeles, Chicago, New York. So when you go, I worked in New York, and you're like, you was working with
already,
the big time.
You know, big name, right?
Yeah, making big money.
Mm. It's a Chinese TV network,
So what was that like? Because I haven't worked in that to that capacity in New York City, but I'm very familiar with New York City. So that very fast pace.
Mm-hmm.
What was that like?
It is very fast pace, and I worked very hard. And then it is 24/7 TV network, so we always have different shifts.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes when we took night shift, and we have to I used to work in the morning 7 a.m. news, so we have to get up at 3 or something in the morning and took a subway at 4 o'clock.
Did you do the live shots in the middle of winter when it's about 15 below zero and the snow is coming?
You don't have to do that, right?
Most of our work is in the studio, and unless we go out to interview somebody.
Right.
But we had some very interesting experience because at that time there was a, I don't know if you remember the blackout.
The
whole city was shut down. And then our studio is at 12 floors, so we have to climb.
Oh my God.
Right.
And then because the blackout, so we use generator to
get electricity.
Yeah, to get electricity. So we went to the roof to do our broadcast. We move our studio up to the roof to do the broadcast. And
that's
fun. 2 days, every day we have to climb, and it's very interesting. And then there was another accident, so the subway shut down, the strike.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, subway workers, they had strike. So we have to get our own transportation.
Okay.
Somebody even walk to the office.
Now, let's go back to you. You said 5 years ago.
5 years ago.
That you...
Yes, that I've been doing. Since the Shen Yun has been, in business since 2006.
Since 2006.
Right. And then I know that they start coming to Orlando, I think it was 2008 or 9.
Yeah.
Right, 8 or 9. But I didn't know about the show at that time.
Okay.
So I knew about the show when I started practicing Falun Gong. So that's when I started helping out. 2012.
Okay. Well, give us the history of the show, because you gave me a little history of the show, and how did the show begin, and why you think the show is so important.
Well, if you go back to the history, since the communists, took over in China, they tried to abolish all the culture, traditional, things, values of the Chinese people. So this group of people, they come together and want to revive that tradition, that all this Chinese culture that is being almost wiped out in China.
Okay.
And
see, now, when I think about, because that's a big show.
It is.
Now, I've never been to the show, but I know it's a big show.
It's
knowing what I know and being part of.
It's a phenomenal undertaking.
Being part of shows and knowing what it takes to produce a show. But listening to what you're saying and trying to tell the story on that stage, that had to take a lot.
Sure.
And can you kind of
But you have to understand what a culture as, you know, rich, mm-hmm. like Chinese right. culture. Right. I mean, there's no way in 2 hours you can learn that, right?
Right.
However, what they do is Shen Yun is a showcase of, you know, dances, mm-hmm. Classical, authentic mm-hmm. classical Chinese dance, mm-hmm. music, mm-hmm. You know, live orchestra and stuff. And they, what they try to do is they want to show you the essence of the culture. Not the, I mean, you know, you're talking not about the cover of it, it's the essence of the culture, the values of it, okay. which is based on divine. The Chinese people believe that their culture is being handed out from the divine beings. Mm-hmm. So it's based on, you know, Lao Tzu, based on Confucius, mm-hmm. on Buddhism. Mm-hmm. So all that, they want to, you know, kind of revive that values that is being lost in China. So you see the essence of it, and through dances, through music, you know, they want to touch the heart and revive that, awake that soul, you know. Mm-hmm. So they would remember all those cultures that are being lost.
Well, what I was trying to hit on was bringing everybody together.
Mm-hmm.
And I just wonder what it was like that very first year. I can't imagine. You know, from the whole process, because you're bringing all these people together and then you're putting on this magnificent show, because I know when you went out to, I mean, I know when they started it, that it just couldn't be just like,
no,
it had to
of
be,
of course, yeah, it
boom,
has a process,
it had to be,
right,
yeah, yeah,
right.
But it probably started out here and it ended up here.
Well, you know, Shen Yun is
a
non-profit.
Shen Yun, it's a non-profit organization. It's mm-hmm. headquartered in New York, actually, at the mm-hmm. office at New York.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's like what Dr. Van said, it's because of the mission. They feel it's a very important to revive this 5,000 years Chinese civilization. So mm-hmm. a group of talented artists in 2006, actually, I think it's before 2006, maybe 2004, and they start
work on it.
Working on it to think how to group more people, because those people share the same mission. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
they want to revive this 5,000 years civilization. So a lot of them actually from all over the world,
mm-hmm.
and they gather together in Upper State New York. And they formed this non-profit Shen Yun Performing Arts, and they started their debut in 2006 in New York,
mm-hmm.
and at the beginning they had only one group, one dance group and one
touring.
One touring group. So they include live orchestra and dance,
mm-hmm.
and then now they have four group, and the touring simultaneously around the world.
I'm going to skip something real quick because I'm going to go back because I'm going to skip. But do they have a downtime?
Yeah, for practice and stuff.
No, well, I meant the show is year round.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And
they usually start the show around December,
okay.
November or December, and the show probably end around May.
Okay.
And then they go back to your base, which is New York.
Okay.
Where they practice for the brand new show. Like I told you, every year is a brand new show.
Oh,
the format
wow.
is the same,
okay.
but the show is different. New choreography, new dances,
wow.
new costume, which every time they go, it's like over 400 sets of handmade costume, one by one. So it's a big undertaking. It's really...
Wow, that is wow.
And you know, Shen Yun is a world-class show because all the dancers are being recruited from all over the world, among the top, you know, dancers.
Mm-hmm.
And then when they join the company, they're going into training,
mm-hmm.
to a school. They have a prep school,
wow.
where
it's
they have to be trained.
Yeah. Academy of Arts.
Because they have to learn about authentic classical Chinese dance. They have to learn about Chinese, you know, traditions and stuff like that.
Traditional
right.
Chinese culture.
And you know, all those dancers, they are connected, you know, origin with either Chinese or parents from Hong Kong or from Taiwan, whatever, but they have some, and there are some that were born, you know, in Taiwan, but most of the kids were born here, right?
They're from all over the world, actually.
Yeah,
they're kind of a second generation.
Right.
Yeah.
So they come in with a mission. They know their mission. If they like it, then they sign up for it and go to school to learn more about the Chinese classical dance, which is, you know, different.
Okay. Now, what would be the youngest person in this show?
The youngest person in the show?
Mm-hmm. Most of them are teenagers.
Okay.
Yeah, so I'm not sure exactly, but maybe, you know, 13, 14.
13, 14. And
they started training.
Right.
Then, yeah. I don't know.
See,
what's the age.
You know, I won't ask the oldest person.
They don't have one.
Right, right.
Do you have no old person in there?
Well, what I meant by old, well, it's old in the sense that because of what they do.
Yes.
From an athletic standpoint.
Right, right.
That's old.
Right.
Early.
Yeah.
In the sense of, like, you know, of being an athlete on a high
right,
level.
Right, right.
You kind of tap out around 30 something.
But you know, they know, because we have seen some older mm-hmm. dancer become choreographer
or
teacher. Mm-hmm. You know, they train the younger kids.
Mm-hmm.
So I think they know when they can dance, as you know.
So now you said five years ago that you
mm-hmm.
became involved.
Mm-hmm.
And so tell me how that happened.
How that happened?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I told you I love the art, and I guess I have something with the Chinese as far as ancestors or whatever. I just
mm-hmm.
love Chinese,
mm-hmm.
you know, performance and shows and, you know, all operas and all kind of stuff. So
mm-hmm.
I went and see the show. I look on the TV
mm-hmm.
and I saw the show, and it was in Jacksonville.
Okay.
So I bought the tickets and I went all the way to Jacksonville and watched it.
Mm-hmm.
And I just love it, you know. So, and then after that, I start practicing Falun Gong, and then from then on, just go on with when the show come, we start volunteering
mm-hmm.
and, you know, helping out, because, you know, it's like you say, it's a phenomenal undertaking. And the show has, you know, depends a lot on volunteers.
Oh, okay.
Look at that. They are, you know, like the cast, they come is over probably about 100 people,
mm-hmm.
half dancers and half members of the orchestra.
Mm-hmm.
And then people who work backstage, I mean, how many you have? And they have to transport, you know, uniforms, instruments from the orchestra,
mm-hmm.
props, and, you know, all that kind of stuff. So they depend a lot on volunteers. So they call on volunteers. So we just volunteer.
And how did you become involved again?
I think I at that time, like I said, I worked for the Chinese TV Network, and
mm-hmm.
this Chinese TV Network is one of their media sponsors.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what I got involved to say, and I watched the show. I had the opportunity to watch the first show in New York in
mm-hmm.
2006. And I had the opportunity to watch each year's Shen Yun show, and I like it so much. So I want to volunteer my time to help, to help promote the show.
Now you told me that this show is not allowed
in China.
We're gonna talk about that. But how did you decide to go into this field? I mean, the field that you're in.
Oh, because I'm originally from communist China,
mm-hmm.
so I know in China they totally destroyed the authentic Chinese culture,
mm-hmm.
because I had my earlier education in China. At that time, I know they tell us the old ancient books. It's all rubbish. They say it's all superstitious. Do not believe in all the old things.
They burn out.
The authentic Chinese culture is just rubbish. Don't study it. So the Communist Party came about 60 years ago. They even distorted the history book. So whatever the information we learn is not a truthful traditional Chinese culture. So it's only when I came to New York, to the United States, when
mm-hmm.
I encountered Shen Yun, I realized, oh, my culture is such
mm-hmm.
a profound.
I was thinking about this before you came on the show, and because I was listening to what you were saying about how they would not allow the show. And then just knowing what I know, and then I started thinking, because that's just my personality, because as a person of color with our own issues within my culture, now we're all ignorant of each other's culture in a sense. And then I know that, well, you know what, let me be careful how I say this. As a person of color, when we see someone of your origin, we don't think of separation. And it's so far from what that is. Because if we don't understand your history, we can kind of link all of you together and look at you and don't think that you have any issues among yourselves.
Right.
Because we all see you the same, is what I'm trying to say.
Right, right.
Because we don't know your history.
Right.
So if we see someone that may look Asian, we don't understand the same stuff that we
exactly.
go through. You know, because we have the same issues, the same problems, in the sense of our own culture,
right.
our own people.
Yes.
And then we're trying to find ourselves, we're trying to find our history, who we are, and the things that's been destroyed among ourselves. But then when we hear your story, it's just, it's all really the same.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And it's just, I'm not a real good martial artist, but I've been around it for a very long time, and understanding how that came to be, and the struggles and the fights, and how.
You practice martial arts?
Don't say that out loud.
You know, martial arts is very closely related to dance, because it shares the same pronunciation.
Exactly.
So if dance becomes civil, that is, if martial arts becomes civil, that's dance, and dance in the battlefield, they can you know, martial arts.
Yeah,
yeah.
I already know I wouldn't want to mess with her.
Yeah.
But understanding how that came to be, especially for survival, and people not knowing the history, and it's just still trying to figure out what that is about. I don't know what that's about, that whatever that separation is in mankind and the dominance. It's just strange to me, just like they want to destroy the history, or they don't want you to know, and it's just like, what is that really about?
Well, you know, if you look at the history, you know, if you know something about the communism,
mm-hmm.
you
right.
know, especially, you know, the Chinese Communist Party,
mm-hmm.
they are officially kind of, they are atheists. They don't believe in God.
Okay.
There's no God, there's no nothing. It's just them. They are for themselves, you know. The party mm-hmm. is it, okay?
Okay?
So the culture, and then you have to understand too, the culture of Chinese, of China, a long time ago, traditionally, it was believed that it was handed down by divine beings from heaven.
Okay.
So like I was telling you, it's from, you know, the looking, going back to find your own self,
mm-hmm.
from the Lao, from the Confucius, which has integrity,
mm-hmm.
Honesty, loyalty, and from Buddhism, compassion, and all that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
All of that is have divine, you know, things in there, like, so they related to that.
Okay.
Then when they think about culture, especially China,
okay.
they want to abolish it because it has some connection to the divine beings that can't be. That's it.
It's scary.
Yeah.
It doesn't make sense,
right.
but.
And the thing is that it's being, you know, kind of wiped out, so it's dangerous because, you know, a country without a culture,
right.
you're lost. That's the soul of the nation.
Right.
I think communism is same as North Korea. They try to control people's mind. They don't
mm-hmm.
want you to have your own thinking.
Mm-hmm.
They don't want you to have your own belief.
Mm-hmm.
So they have their own propaganda about the Communist Party's culture. What that culture is atheism. There's no heaven, no earth, no God at all.
Just them.
Just Communist Party. Marxism is the only belief you can believe in. So if you believe in anything else, that's different from the communism methodology. So it's, they will put you as the nation's enemy. You are dissidents. So that's why they have so many movements to destroy the culture, like 10 years of Cultural Revolution from 1966 to 1976.
Mm-hmm.
So during that 10 years period of time, they destroy all the antiques, all the old paintings, all the calligraphies,
scriptures,
sculptures, and old temples, old buildings, anything ancient. They just destroy. They say those are rubbish, those are superstitious. The Confucianism, everything, they destroy it. And so it's a big loss for the country.
Wow, that's
10 years. Those people, they even break into your house. If you have some private collection, they just break into your house,
take it
and burn it. You cannot have any private collection.
Now, have you had any friends that have had a chance to escape that was a part of it in recent years?
I escaped from it, but and you know, my grandfather, he died during that 10-year Cultural Revolution. He was a Christian father, Christian priest.
Oh, really?
Before Communist Party came.
Mm-hmm.
So when Communist Party came, because of his profession in the past, he was a Christian.
Mm-hmm.
He was severely persecuted to death. Yeah.
Wow.
So after Communist Party came, he became a postman, and then under a lot of persecution, then died very young. I never seen him. He died before I was born. Yeah. It's just so many people were killed under Communist Party's ruling. So it is a statistic that 70 million to 80 million Chinese were died because of Communist Party's persecution in China during the last 60 years.
Oh, wow.
They died unnaturally. Yeah.
Now, as far as the show and the story that the show is trying to tell, and how can I add that? It's going to sound like a crazy question, but how deep do they get into it in the sense of the expression of trying to express or tell the story? Is that a crazy question?
No.
It's a 2-hour show. This 2-hour show, they have 20 mini programs. So each program is about 4 or 5 minutes long.
Mm-hmm.
In between of each program, they have MC came out to explain the background, explain what the next program is all about.
Mm-hmm.
So those 20 programs, most of them are dance. Some of them are like a soloist.
Mm-hmm.
Soloist like a tenor, soprano, and
mm-hmm.
Singing. Different
mm-hmm.
stories. A story about history,
mm-hmm.
About myths and the legends. So very quick, 4 or 5 minutes to tell a complete story. For example, you want to know how deep they are. They had a Mulan story in the past year.
Mm-hmm.
You know Mulan.
Are you familiar with the movie Mulan?
Yeah, Disney movie Mulan.
The Disney movie?
No. Help me.
Disney had a very popular movie called Mulan, but that is different. Disney Mulan is different from the true Mulan in Chinese history.
Mm-hmm.
So in the Shen Yun program, he tell the true Mulan story. Mulan is a girl. She joined the army. It's about 1,500 years ago. She's a true character in Chinese history. She joined the army in her father's place because her father was too old. And but got summoned by the emperor, so she tried to protect her father.
So she joined the army for her father.
Yes, but she
disguised
to be a man, and she joined the army for 12 years.
I think that's
So what that story tells, as far as the culture, on that is filial piety,
mm-hmm.
you know, because of the love for the father, because of the pride, you know, because the emperor say you have to go to war, you go to war, you know,
mm-hmm.
you have no choice. So she does that out of that, you know,
mm-hmm.
for loyalty for the country, for you know, filial piety towards her father. So that's the character of you know, the Chinese culture.
Yeah, I mean, so she joined the army for 12 years, and no one knows she's a girl. She even became a general in the army because she's so brave.
So good.
And at 12 years, no one knows she's a girl.
Okay.
So after the war finished, she retired, went back to her village. She dressed like a lady and still look after her old father. Only at that time, the emperor sent messengers, gave her a proclamation. Only at that time, people noticed, she's a girl. She's a lady. And then she was so shocked. So her story become part of history. Yeah, and like Dr. Wen said, she represents two values. One is filial piety, respecting parents, taking care of old parents, and the other is be loyal to the country, sacrifice herself. When the country needs you, just sacrifice yourself, go to the war. That's very touching. That's why when my friends, she has a teenager daughter, she was born and raised in the United States. After she watched the show, she said, "Oh, mom, I should respect you more." So she learned something from the dance.
But you know, yeah. This show is unique in a way that is not only let the world know about this rich culture, but actually let the Chinese people who grew up here, who don't know anything about the Chinese culture, so they can value this and they know where they came from and the roots of it. You
that's
know,
that's a very interesting topic because mm-hmm. listening to everything, well, just understanding the history and growing up in America, that really can screw you up.
Don't say that.
That's true. I mean, because here you're so far from the reality
mm-hmm.
of what you're talking about,
mm-hmm.
you know, being in this culture, in this country,
right.
I mean, kids, and that's one of the things within my culture that we talk about. Kids today have no clue of a separate fountain, a separate bathroom, a separate this, of what it was to be in slavery. They have no
right.
clue. They look at you like, well, no, it really didn't happen. And so to think about the degree of the separation and not having a true understanding, basically it's the same thing as just trying to sit and talk to them.
Yeah.
Because what frustrates you, honestly, because, you know, I'm not old, but I'm old, you know, so when I'm around the older people, and we talk about our youth, especially when you see them with the sagging pants and all the whatever it is,
right.
whatever that's about. It's frustrating because you're saying to me, you don't understand the sacrifice
mm-hmm.
that people made that came before you.
Mm-hmm.
And this is what you, wherever you are up here in your mind and everything, it's frustrating. Because they don't understand the sacrifice and all the lives
mm-hmm.
and the things that people had to go through in order for them to wear their pants down and whatever it is. So that's interesting.
But that's why, you know, people call Shen Yun is the hope of a nation,
mm-hmm.
which is true, you know. Because if you look on the news, Chinese news right now,
mm-hmm.
it's just a mess.
Yeah,
there's no honesty, there's no compassion, they're killing people, they put poison in your food, you know, they have the kids, you know, it's on YouTube, you know, you see the car accident and they left the kids staying there for 20 minutes, nobody took care of her and the truck ran back and ran over her again, you know, I mean, things just happen. So, you know, I know the Communist Party is trying to get China to move up in the ladder, but how can they do that if they just, you know, don't have the three leg and they don't have the leg on environment and on the culture. They're going nowhere.
Yeah,
you know?
So this show is very educational. It's not only entertaining, it's very educational
mm-hmm.
and enlightening. So it has the value of ancient wisdom, 5,000 years of wisdom, and the value, the principles all presented through the dance, through the storytelling dance. The values such as honesty, loyalty, respecting parents, taking
compassion.
Care of old parents, and to be a good person. Those values is also, it's all there. It's all there
wow.
live on stage. Yeah, it's like a educational
But like I say, yeah. It's not just, you know, for the world to know, but it's just for the even the Chinese people who has been away for so long, who grew up here, who know nothing. You ask what is Chinese culture, what represents Chinese culture, they'll say chopstick, you know, a lo mein Chinese food, kung fu. But that's just the outside of it. But the essence of the culture is all presented in here through the dances, mm-hmm. through the music, through the lyrics, through the expressions when they dance, through the stories, you know, myths and stuff. I mean, stories of 5,000 years of history, they bring it to the scene for you to
and
see.
And also, China is the only country that has 5,000 years continuously written history. Mm-hmm. That's why this heritage, I think, is a world treasure. That's why we want to share it with the world. It's not only targeting Chinese audience. No, not at all. It's the world treasure.
Yeah, because there's
so
many
the
other.
Is universal. Those values they present on stage is universal, and those wisdoms they teach you how to overcome difficulties.
And it's recorded,
challenges.
Right? That's the only.
Yeah.
Ancient culture that is recorded throughout 5,000 years. There's, don't get us wrong, there are other ancient culture, mm-hmm. but they didn't survive. They disappeared.
Yeah, but Chinese culture is the only culture that's 5,000 years written history. That's why Communist Party, they worked so hard to
burn it.
They tried to destroy the history. That's for 60 years, they systematically destroyed this culture. So this culture is at the brink of extinction. Mm. So that's why it's very important for our generation to do something to revive it. Otherwise, it will be lost.
Gone.
Yeah.
Have this ever been done? And this is a question for you. You probably would know this. From the very start of the production. A documentary from the start of when the new season starts, when they sit down to go over, like, okay, these are the changes, these are the things we're going to do, this is the story that we're going to tell, this is how we're going to dance, this is how we're going to do this, and this is the music. That would be a great documentary from the start to the finish of the creation of the show. Have that ever been done? Do you know?
No, we are not part of Shen Yun Performing Arts, so we are not involved with the production.
No, but,
so.
But I'm saying, I'm giving you an idea.
Person who handles it, you know, he handles everything. Mm-hmm. And if you watch the show every year,
mm-hmm.
you can see that the message is different
right,
each
right.
year as
but,
the,
right,
the
but,
evolution
but,
of the...
Right, but what that's why I'm saying it'll be great to see from the very start the whole creation of it.
Mm-hmm. They have some video about it on their website, shenyun.com.
Mm-hmm.
They have an introduction about Shen Yun Performing Arts. They have an introduction about classical Chinese dance, and also information about their live orchestra, because their live orchestra is very unique. It's a combination of Eastern and Western music instruments.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a very creative thing.
How many people are in the orchestra?
About 60.
About 60
mm-hmm.
people?
Mm-hmm.
And how many cities do they tour?
They tour, you know, 120 cities around the world.
Yeah, last year, yeah.
120.
120.
Mm-hmm.
So they start touring in...
United States.
In what month?
November or December.
Yeah.
Right.
And then they go until you said May?
Right.
Yeah, yeah. So.
And they all regroup back to work for 6 months to work on the new show. Redo all the, make all the costume,
well,
new
well, see,
choreography.
That's what I'm saying, the whole thing is being documented, is what I'm saying, because
yeah.
it sounds very fascinating.
If you see, you should see the costume is very unique, because you know how vast China is?
Mm-hmm.
Every province is different. There's ethnic, you know, the ethnicity is different.
Mm-hmm.
Their, you know, how do you say it? Outfit,
well,
and the costume
well,
are different.
Like I said, I'm not a good martial artist, but I've been around martial arts long enough, and it's the funniest thing, just the little difference in this style versus this style, it's just like, really? Because whatever that is, that right there was made, that was handmade in France. France made it.
Oh, really?
But yeah. And the gentleman that owned one of the local martial arts stores saw that. Now, unbeknownst to us, we said something in reference to, well, you know, you can make this and sell it in your store. And he made reference to something that's on there that has nothing to do with this culture versus this culture, because you're not thinking about it.
Right,
that.
Right.
And so he said, no, well, that wouldn't work with that. But he didn't mean it in a way, but he said you would have to make one for, like, each culture in a sense. You know, like, you know, make one for this style, make one for this style. But as the open person, you wouldn't really think about that. But it's just basically what you're talking about.
Well, we've been talking about that. We want to tell them what Shen Yun means?
Yes.
Shen means divine, and the Yun means beauty. Altogether means the beauty of the divine beings dancing. So, because we believe Chinese culture was bestowed from the heaven, and there's a lot of divinely inspired myths and legends. Those myths and legends has some interesting interaction between humankind and the divine beings. Yeah, so those stories. Yeah.
The stories.
Yeah. So you can see it on Shen Yun stage. Those interaction between humankind and divine beings.
I can't wait to see the show, because you keep talking about it telling a story.
Yeah.
And it telling a story, and it's kind of like you're
you know, in all the culture, they have myths, they have stories that we transferred down generation to generation from God to the being. And so the Chinese people believe their culture is being handed down by the divine beings. Mm-hmm. So they were very close to God's heavens at the time. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know, you know, in the old day, even in some of the history we read here, you know, you do something good, you get rewarded right away. And, you know, you do something bad, you could walk out and get struck by lightning. You know, if we were so good, so close to the divine beings. Yeah. So that's what she said Shen Yun means.
And you said the show is about 2 hours
long. 2 hours plus
with
15
minutes
intermission. So, 2 hours, 15 minutes,
And I know the show is usually sold out. And what are the prices of the tickets?
It's at Dr. Phillips Performing Arts, and it's from 60 to 200.
Wow! And they're sold out. And it is here on February 9th and
10th. Only two nights.
Only two.
Mm-hmm.
And
this is the last show in Florida. Okay, they tour around already. St. Petersburg, Lakeland, you know. Jacksonville. Melbourne.
I'm from Jacksonville, and I did see the promo for it when I was up there. So, it leaves Florida, and it goes where?
They go somewhere until May. I don't know their schedule, but.
So now, is it just one show, or is there more than one show? Because it's just one show.
One. To practice is. And if you see different company perform, you will be amazed. Exactly the same, you know. Two different companies, they do the same, you know, numerals. They do the same show, the same program. And it's exactly the same. It's just really something else. It's their practice. Hundreds of people practice that. So you see some, you know, other tour performing it, it's the same.
Well, see, now I'm confused. You said some other tour?
Tour company. Remember she told you that we have four now that go around the world?
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's what I was asking.
The same content. Four company, what they perform is the same.
Well, that's what I was asking. Is it just one show? Is it other? But you said there's four. Four different companies.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Four groups.
Well, four groups. Yeah, that's what I was asking. Is it just this one, or are there others, but it's the same show is what I was asking. But I guess I didn't ask it.
Same show.
But it's the same show, but it's different groups.
Groups, right.
Yeah.
Okay. And so they also travel outside the country.
Oh, yes.
And what are some of the other countries that they go to?
They go to Europe. they go to Australia and New Zealand. They go to South America, North America, Canada.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, South America. They will go to Mexico, and in
Italy.
Yeah, in Europe they go to Italy, France, Germany.
And on the eastern side, they go to Korea,
mm-hmm.
Japan.
Yeah, Asia.
Yeah.
But so like in Japan.
Yeah.
Is it how's it welcome in Japan?
It's very welcome anywhere they go. People love it. There's no language or no nationality barrier.
Mm-hmm.
People they just love it because
they see it as culture. It. Art,
see,
art,
gonna,
culture,
see,
educational.
See, I'm going to ask you a very ignorant question, okay? And this is on the outside,
mm-hmm.
okay? Because remember when I was talking about just on the outside, when you say, well, understanding the martial arts, trust me, I understand the karate versus
okay.
kung fu, the, trust me, I understand soft versus the hard, and the whole mentality of that. On the outside looking in, you say China, Japan, and you go, well, they're not the same, but yet they're the same. But they're not. It's two totally different countries, in a sense.
Mm-hmm.
And so is there an understanding of the struggle that takes place in China? And as far as Japan understanding that struggle?
You know what? Japanese culture is heavily influenced by traditional Chinese culture.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, Japanese culture is originated from China's Tang Dynasty.
Okay.
Tang Dynasty, I don't know if you know, familiar about different dynasties in
mm-hmm.
China.
Mm-hmm.
Tang Dynasty is from 300 years to 700 years
mm-hmm.
in that history of
mm-hmm.
time. So
mm-hmm.
Tang Dynasty is kind of the peak of traditional Chinese culture. So Japanese culture is actually originated from Tang Dynasty.
Mostly all the Oriental, right? Like
Vietnamese
actually, country
Chinese
are from that too.
Actually, Asian traditional Chinese culture influenced a lot of Asian countries,
yeah.
like
okay.
Vietnamese, Korea, and the Japanese.
And we can identify with it.
Someone is asking, okay, I missed that, but I think we talked about, they asked, where are the rehearsals held? There's another one. Is the show in all Chinese, is there a translation?
No, it's all dance and music.
Right.
But there's, like she said, there's an MC who would walk you through
mm-hmm.
what is the next year. So
yeah,
even if they're not that, you would understand.
Yeah, the MC will explain in English what's the show about, what's the background, and what's the show is all about. So
mm-hmm.
everyone understands. They have a program book explaining the details of the book,
yeah.
of the show.
And
the
dance,
story.
The music, it was so well, you know, done that you don't even need that. You would understand.
Yeah.
They dance the story, you know.
And
it's just different people. They have different background. They understand if you know more about Chinese culture, you understand deeper.
Mm-hmm.
You can understand deeper meaning from the storytelling. For example, a lot of people watch the show multiple times. There's some people watch the same show five times. Each time they enlighten to something new.
Right.
Yeah, because different layers, layer after layer after layer. For me, each time I watch the show, I understand a little bit more.
Someone wants to know, how can you audition for the show?
That will be hard.
Oh,
yeah.
Actually, they are all constantly recruiting musicians
mm-hmm.
for their live orchestra,
yeah.
mm-hmm.
and they're also recruiting dancers. Actually, you can, yeah.
Well, you actually answered that question. Does the show travel overseas? Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You said what Shen Yun stands for.
Right.
Yeah.
Tell us again, because
Shen means divine,
mm-hmm.
and Yun means beauty.
Mm-hmm.
All together, it means the beauty of the divine beings dancing.
Now, did I ask this question? Is this, well, actually, yes. Do you know when it'll be back in Orlando again?
Every year.
If we're lucky, next year.
Yeah.
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 we don't even, that's why, you know, I really encourage people who just come and take the journey with us, because it's very unique show. It's a splendid, you know, phenomenal. I mean, there's no words that can say. You just have to experience it. It's something else, all right? So because every year, things change, you know, so I don't know. Like I told you, it's a big undertaking. And next year, we don't even know if we're going to be able to invite a show. It depends on the venue. It depends on monetary. It depends on a lot of things. So, you know, if you have a chance, go see it.
Well, yeah, but and that was one of my questions, but you answered it right away, and that is that it is a yearly show, because you said that they should.
Right, it's supposed to be, you know, yearly, and you know, like always have success. The people, they've been here 5 years, you know, they've been coming back, so hopefully.
Yeah. Well, I'm looking forward to seeing the show. Thank you for blessing me with that. I really can't wait to see it. I mean, I'm just sitting here, I've learned so much, and I can't wait to go see the show. Is there any, we actually have about 45 seconds to go.
Oh,
but
time goes fast.
Yeah.
But is there any last thing that you want to say about the show, anything, you know, at all that you want to enlighten us with? Wow. And I hope I didn't ask too many stupid questions.
No. There's no stupid questions.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah.
But you know, when she said about the divine beauty of the divine dancing, when you see the dancers dance, you will see they all believe that, you know, to perform the dance properly, they have to be good inside. They have to cultivate themselves. Their inner self has to be good too.
Remember
I told you that they all practice meditation and stuff to you know, bring themselves up to par so they can perform to the utmost of the dance. The inner beauty will show. That's what, you know, Shen Yun mean to me.
Yeah, well, I can only imagine understanding what it takes. I mean, just watching it and seeing it and seeing how gifted they are. And people standing on the outside have no idea the hard work and the dedication that it takes to put on that caliber.
Yeah. All those dancers, they are the world top dancers. They won dance awards. Most of them are golden awards. Yeah, you know, they are the best of the best.
So when are we gonna see you on stage dancing?
No, when you dance, she come and interview you.
Yeah. Well, I want to thank the both of you so much for taking the time out. And
no, thank you for having us.
Trust me.
Hopefully, people will know more about the show, because, like, you don't know much about the show, you see? So how many more don't know much about the show? So we're probably not doing, you know, good in promoting it. We need to let people know more about it.
You know what? That's something to really sit down and probably kind of, you know, talk about, because that caliber of a show, more people should know about it.
Yeah, this is a world-class show, you know. It's not just a show. It's really, if you see their dance techniques and stuff, you know, all these kids, they when they join the school, the prep school, they have to be trained at least 6 years before they can go on stage.
Yeah, yeah.
And they are already professional dancers.
Yeah, and every day they train about 6 hours to 8 hours training. Even they have the performance at night, they still in daytime, they still have class, they still have training, keep training.
They have school too, they have schooling
too. I wonder, because now that I'm old, I would love to talk to someone who's been part of this and just, what is that like mentally, emotionally, and physically? Because when you're young, you know, you can do that. But then as time goes by, just would love to talk to them.
Yep.
Just to hear what they have to say. What?
Well, you go on the shenyun.com. Mm-hmm. There are some of the dancers that, you know,
they have their blog.
Their book, their blog, they write up and they say, but they all cultivate. Every time how they surpass, they overcome all this, you know, is they cultivate themselves. Either they meditate, they look at themselves and see how they can improve. They really try hard, because it's hard. you know, they have to stay at the in school, away from the family.
And well, in order for you
very
to
hard.
In order for you to do something like that, you have to be extremely
hardworking,
disciplined. Disciplined in order to get to that level. And the thing is that we see the show, but we don't see what it took for that show to get to that point and for those people to be at that level.
And how much work they do, you know, the people who do the costume,
well,
handmade,
well,
each beads, you know, each has to be sewn, and they depend on the volunteer.
Wow.
Yeah, like if Serene wants to go up to the mountain, is where they were based, stay there 3 months just to do the sewing. And it's all volunteer. Mm-hmm. You know that?
Well, Serene, Dr. Nguyen, I want to thank you so much for coming on and giving me some of your time.
Sure. No, we have to thank you. Wish
thank
that
you
we, you know, can do it earlier.
No, well,
maybe
you
the
know
show
what?
Can be better.
Whenever you want to come on the show, if you want to, I mean, I would love for you to come because you kind of open my eyes up to something, and I think we need more dialogue to help educate us overall, you know, and I'm serious because, you know, sometimes we're so caught up into our own little world that when...
We, both Serene and I, we practice Falun Gong, which is an ancient Chinese, you know, cultivation of mind and body, where you look within yourself and it's based on truth, compassion, and tolerance. That's all we base on. You know, always be compassionate toward people. That's one thing that we all missed. You know, and we don't tolerate each other very well. We have no patience, and that's why we go to war. Even within the house, right? So that's what we practice, and I think if everybody knows about it, maybe one day we can and talk about that.
After
the Shen Yun.
Well, so let's make a date for like sometime in March.
Wonderful.
You know, so you...
We would love people to know more, you know, because it's, you know, I retire. I retire now. I don't practice medicine anymore. But I practice medicine in a different way. I treat people by telling them to cultivate, to be a better person. So you don't have to take medicine because... If you don't worry about, you know, how to harm other people, you don't hate anybody, you don't hold grudges to anybody, you won't have ulcer, you know, that type of thing. So, and then there's a set of exercises you do that'll keep you healthy. So.
Well, with that, again, I want to thank you for blessing me this evening.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Next time we'll know where the house is.
All right, next time they will know where the house is. Want to thank them both for coming on the show, blessing us this evening. We're going to invite them both back on the show sometime in the next few weeks. You want to make sure that you tune in for that. As Dr. Robinson would say, the journey is from me to you and from you to me so we can reach a higher ground. Thank you for watching. And don't forget to check out the show.